our apples and snakes. Poetry with bite.
I watch as she gets into the taxi. She looks back and I let the look linger. A couple of bottles of wine and some awkward moments down the line, a little bit too long. And she tells the driver the address of her flat filled with her unpacked suitcases. And then she shakes her head. And I watch as she shakes her head. And all I'm thinking is, I can't be that to you, taxi girl. A couple of nights ago, I was in the same bar, talking to a woman who was being anything other than herself. She was presenting a peer pressure informed image of what she presumed my so-called but really non-existent masculinity wanted her to be. And I carried on conversing, carrying the same wallet stuffed with insecurities in my back pocket, only buying drinks with petty chit-chat and hoping like hell she doesn't ask me to reach into that wallet to pay for anything. And I took her home. But I can't be that to you, taxi girl. Yesterday, someone said to me, they said, Leon, you're a bastard who doesn't act like a bastard. You're a needy, insecure twat who seeks my attention for your own selfish validation, who quotes Sylvia Plath to achieve your Henry Miller ambitions, and you can fuck right off, mate. And I denied it, and I denied it, and I denied it, and I denied it, but they were right. I won't be that to you. Now I'm going to get it right this time. Because if I'm ever that to you, it won't be with a guy who let rejection teach him everything and love teach him nothing. It won't be with a guy who still lives in a world where people treat windows like mirrors. Checking the reflection to make sure their hair's the right side, I just got out of bed with a stranger this morning, it's why they're scared to open them. And if I'm ever that to you, it won't be some stupid, drunken one-night stand because you're lonely and I'm available. Because you're more than that. You're like a preacher who doesn't even preach, but taught me the truth with your eyes, reconfirming my faith in religion. You're a rock and roll Marilyn Monroe. You're a ready to stay up till 3 a.m. in the morning talking about waiting for a sunrise, myth-busting insomniac. You're a truth-telling jester, a wisdom-infused yarn spinner, a soft-landing sucker punch, and you deserve better than that. So let's stop with the cutting small talk. Let me take you by the hand, taxi girl, and let us agree to be our best selves. And then maybe I'll be that to you.